extra.
Is it help on ground?
I guess it was.
Cowboy boots?
No.
The guy with beige cowboy?
No, I don't think so. I didn't look at his feet. I wonder which ones are first and second person.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Carlette died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. On the day of her baptism, Carlette put on Christ. On the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed in glory. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Carlette, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
The first reading will be from the book of the prophet Isaiah, and that's going to be read by Michael Favor, Carlette's nephew. Michael?
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples. The web that is woven over all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day, it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into light. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into light. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. You have set me a banquet of love in the face of hatred, crowning me with love beyond my power to hold. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my fears, from death into life. Surely your kindness and mercy follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of my God forevermore. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Rudy and Susan Dombrowski, Carlette's nephew, niece and nephew, please come up, and they're going to read from the book of Revelation.
Start here. A reading from the book of Revelation. John saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth has passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of the heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I hear a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I will make all things new. I am the Alpha and I am the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life, giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and there will be my son," the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Out of the tomb he is risen. He has conquered death, opened heaven to all believers.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Mary came to where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping and the Jews who had come with her also weeping, he became deeply troubled and said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to him, "Sir, come and see." And Jesus wept. So the Jews said, "See how much he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not the one who opened the eyes of the blind man have done something so that this man would not have died?" So Jesus came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay across it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the dead man's sister, said to him, "Lord, by now there will be a stench. He has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. And Jesus raised his eyes and said, "Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always hear me, but because of the crowd here, I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me." And when he had said this, he cried out in a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out." The dead man came out, tied hand and foot with burial bands, and his face was wrapped in a cloth. So Jesus said to the crowd, "Untie him and let him go free." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. For everyone, believer and unbeliever alike, death packs a punch. It knocks us to the mat. Harder in some circumstances, less hard in others, but hard nonetheless. But unlike the unbeliever, we believers get up. As believers, we view and approach death not from this side of the grave, but from the other, not from this side of life, but beyond life. And we do this because we are believers, believers in the resurrection. 2,000 years ago, our crucified Lord suffered the worst kind of death known to man, and he still did one better than death. He conquered it, not just for himself, but for every believer who is to follow. And Carlette McNevins is living this belief. Jesus got up from the mat after his death, and so did Carlette, and so will every believer who follows, until someday we're all together again. So where do we go from here? Well, I'm not going anywhere, because we are believers, believers in Jesus who conquered death, and there is no more comforting place to be than right here with our Lord in his church, who is Jesus, near the Eucharist, who is Jesus, where Carlette was faithful. She had a special devotion to St. Rita. And I'm very pleased to say that I will be leading a pilgrimage this October to Italy. And one of our parishioners asked that we go to Cascia, which is the hometown of St. Rita. So I will be sure to remember Carlette in my prayers when we visit that shrine. Rita is the female version of Jude. St. Jude is the patron saint of desperate cases. Rita is the patron saint of desperate cases. And I am quite sure that Carlette heard similar words that were spoken at the tomb of Lazarus as she reached the gates. To the family Strange and family McNevins, who came to greet her, Jesus said, "Untie her. Untie Carlette of her dementia and let her go free." Amen.
Would Carlette's grandchildren please go to the rear of the church to bring up the offertory gifts?
Gentle mother,
peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father.
Please stand. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Carlette, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which shall be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Carlette, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof.
But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for light. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you in the Maria gratia plena, Ave, Ave Dominus, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris, ventris tui, Iesus.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Carlette may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Carlette, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Soul and let eternal life
until we meet again.
See, as we commend our sister Carlette, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did the grace gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing
go forth, Christian soul, from this world. In the name of God, the Almighty Father, who created you, in the name of Jesus Christ, who suffered for you, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who was poured out upon you. Go forth, faithful Christian. May you live in peace this day. May your home be with God in heaven, with Mary, the Virgin Mother, and with all the members of your family who now welcome you into God's eternal love. Carlette, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secure. As long as life endures, my chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns. The sun forbear to shine.